This Headless Professor video is about classical conditioning. In all forms of psychological research, we have to identify several components. One of these is the organism, the subject, the person or animal that we are studying. Another factor is the response, in other words, the behavior of that subject. Another factor is the stimulus, the energy and the environment of the subject that can be perceived by that organism. This is the basic relationship in all of psychology. We're looking at how a stimulus is presented to the organism and elicits a response from that organism. In the case of classical conditioning, we're going to be using two stimuli which are paired together. One easy way of remembering this is to just look at the word classical. Do you see the two letters, S, S, right in the middle? Well, each one of those stands for a stimulus. And so when you see the two S's together, that says two paired stimuli in classical conditioning. The first of the stimuli that we're going to talk about is called the UCS. That stands for an unconditioned stimulus, one that naturally elicits the response that we are studying. The other stimulus is called the CS, the conditioned stimulus. That too will elicit the same response, but only after the organism has learned to respond to it, only after this new reflex has been acquired. Indeed, that conditioned stimulus starts off being incapable of eliciting that response. It starts off as being neutral. What happens before the acquisition of a new reflex is that the neutral stimulus is presented, and that is followed by the unconditioned stimulus. Then the organism responds to the unconditioned stimulus. But after the new reflex has been acquired through many different trials, as soon as the conditioned stimulus is presented to the organism responds the same way that it did for just the unconditioned stimulus. The best example of this comes from the classic case of Ivan Pavlov. He studied a dog. The response that Pavlov studied was the dog's salivation. The unconditioned stimulus which elicits the response of salivation was the presentation of food. The neutral stimulus, which became conditioned in Pavlov's research, was the sound of a bell. Here's the way that worked. Pavlov began by presenting the neutral stimulus, the bell, then followed it with the food, and the dog responded by salivating. After acquisition had taken place, when Pavlov rang the bell, the dog would respond by salivating to the sound of the bell. Well, we don't have one of Pavlov's dogs here today, so we're not going to use that example. But I will say that all forms of classical conditioning can be extinguished when we continue to present that conditioned stimulus without following it with the unconditioned stimulus. The organism will simply get tired of responding to that conditioned stimulus unless the UCS is also there. We don't have a dog here today, but we do have a dinosaur. This dinosaur is Gigi. And that stands for Godzilla's granddaughter. And we're going to do a little bit of classical conditioning with Gigi. So the organism is a dinosaur. The response that this dinosaur makes is to open her mouth. The unconditioned stimulus for eliciting that response is food. And we have to find the favorite food for a dinosaur. And after seeing that Godzilla movie, I know what the favorite food is of dinosaurs, like Godzilla. It's a Japanese policeman. So, our conditioned stimulus will be a sound. And the sound is Santa Claus making a rattle sound. Thank you, Santa Claus. So, are we ready? Let's see. Here's Gigi the dinosaur. Now we make the sound, and Gigi doesn't do anything. She certainly doesn't open her mouth because that's not necessarily something that she could eat. But if we make this sound and immediately follow it with her favorite food, Gigi will open her mouth and take away her food. Yes, indeed. So here's what we have done. We have taken a neutral stimulus, followed it with an unconditioned stimulus, presented it to our organism, and our organism has responded. So, after we do this a number of times, here is what is going to happen. As soon as we present the conditioned stimulus, the organism will respond by opening her mouth. In this particular case, what would extinction mean? Oh dear, I said the wrong word with dinosaurs, didn't I, when I talked about extinction? Let me reassure Gigi that when we're talking about extinction, we're not talking about the extinction of the organism. No, we're talking about an extinguishing, an extinction, as it's called, of the behavior of opening the mouth. If we kept ringing the bell, or in this case, Socrates or Santa Claus's rattle, Gigi would keep on making her mouth go open, but eventually she would get tired of that. And we would say that her response has been extinguished. That's classical conditioning in the example that we have here today. No dinosaurs were harmed in the making of this study.